So today we talk about valve springs and when we need stronger valve springs. I explain this now. So now I want to explain you why we need stronger springs. I have make a sketch here with the piston. You can easily recognize that this is our piston. And we have TDC when the intake and the exhaust valve is open. So they are slightly open. This scenario is mainly used on naturally aspirated engines, which are non-turbo. They have this scenario is let's say bigger, because on the non-turbo engine, the engine needs to force all the intake air with fuel. And on the turbo engine, it's a little bit different because we have the boost, so we are forcing the air inside the chamber. So the problem is we cannot make it too long, the opening time from intake and exhaust valves, because then we lose too much. So basically, when this is our boost, I'll calculate with 0.5 bar, for example. So the boost is going inside here, intake valve is open, exhaust valve is open, and then it starts to get here, going here into the exhaust, to the turbo. And now we have this scenario here, when we go here, so all the boost is coming along the valve, the exhaust valve, and it's pushing the valve down. So if the spring, which is here on the top, is not strong enough, the valve will stay open and then we get misfire. And misfire, I can show you very easy. We have make this on the dyno with a special engine. I'll go to the dyno with you now. So that's the dyno comparison with the same engine. I will switch on the cursor so you will see. You will see already here at 4500 RPM, we are starting to get different measurements, which is linked to the springs. You can see the power here is dropping or less than later on with the springs installed. So the thicker line is the when we installed the springs. And the problem was here with this one. So you can see it. And here at this area, it already stops to work at all. We get misfire at this area in VCDS, you can see, but here the engine basically stops to work properly. So we even couldn't go higher in RPM. It feels like when you're driving and somebody's holding you up at the rear, or similar as will you drive against the supersonic wall. So something is stopping you. And also on the torque, you see here, torque-wise, we are dropping here. And here is the end, basically. And with this new springs installed, we can go easily to the limiter. The engine code, which is mostly affected or very famous for this issue, is the BHZ engine code from the 2-liter TFSI, which was first installed in the Audi S3 and also in the Super Copa from Seat, which is the race car, or the Volkswagen Scirocco. They had all the engines inside the BHZ with this issue. But also the engine which came later was the CDL. I would recommend to change the springs already after the aim of 400 horsepower, because as you see here, this is something, it's a drop which is coming very slightly, and you don't feel this, but you will see it on the power. And now we go back to the workshop, so I will show you how to measure the springs correctly. So we are back here with the springs, and I will show you how we measure the springs and what we do with the springs. This is basically a stock spring from the R8. You can easily see it's also magnetic, and already it's rusty, yeah. So which is not very good. And that's our spring, which you see already the coil is much stronger and it's coated. And then on the top of the spring, this diameter is smaller, and on the other side it's bigger, because the spring is a little bit conical. And maybe you know why it is like this, and I would just write it in the comments if you know why this is like that. Then we have the upper retainer, which is steel on the stock spring, and we made this from titanium. And it's very light, and I want to know from you why we make this from titanium. One other important thing also on the TFSI engine, because we talk about TFSI springs now, this is basically only for the TFSI engines. And one scenario is also the upper, the roller, which is, you have this area there, which is coming to the valve. So it, the valve is coming outside, it's touching the valve here. And in some springs, the design is not very good because this part is touching the upper titanium retainer or the whatever retainer they have developed. And then you get an engine failure because you're not pushing the valve, you're pushing the retainer. So on our kits, we especially make the step here and develop the, this upper retainer to the spec, so you have enough space between this one here, like that. So what we do now, I will show you the measurement of the springs. This machine, we can measure once is the stroke, which is going like this. Yeah, we have this one here. And then we can make measure the force. Yeah, the force which is the spring is doing. So now we know that the force from the stock valve spring, which is compared to this one, is too weak. Yeah. Let's calculate, for example, we go now, because the spring is not installed free. It's not like this. There is a preload. So we have, let's say, a preload of this, for example. We go to zero. Yeah. I can make zero now, for example, like this. So now we have a force of 30. And then let's imagine when the valve is open and the boost is coming, it's, let's say we are 1 millimeter, yeah? For example, it's just example value. I don't know the stroke of the camshaft now, it's not important. So let's go to 1 millimeter, we have 37. And now we compare this, and we know with this spring, it's too weak, yeah? So now we take our spring, so we do the same. First we go to the preload, like the spring is installed when the camshaft is not opening the valve. It's the installation preload, basically. Now this is zero. Already now we have a stronger force. And now we go exactly to the same value as before, 1 millimeter, when the camshaft is still open 1 mil. So there you can see the force is 69, nearly 70. And here we know it's enough, because we have proven on the dyno, it's okay, the spring will stay, or the valve will stay closed. It's always a compromise. We don't want to get too much, and we don't want to get, because then you get also, you have to turn around too much, you have too much force to turn the engine, especially the head. When you install the springs, for example, or other upgrade springs, and you try to turn the engine, or only the head, for example, you will see it's very, you need much more force to turn the engine, which is also, on the other hand, bad, because you have too much, you lose too much power for turning the engine. Basically, that's it. We will make another video also with the maximum lift, for example, which is also important. Yeah, when you go on block, for example, if you know the camshaft, the stroke of the cam is 12 mil, for example, we can go down like here. We go to 12 mil, and then we still need to have a reserve, because when the spring is on block, you will break the spring and you will damage the engine. But this will come in another video. So take care.